first impressions, shall we? Let's do it. YouTube, hello ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Mikey Cologne, and if you tuned in, people, thank you for doing so. If you're new here, thank you for tuning in. To all my subscribers, thank you ever so much for the support. It all means a hell of a lot, it really does. Right, we have a Latafa fragrance to unbox. It is Mahia Legacy. I believe I've got a few more in this line, haven't tried any. Don't know anything about this. I was looking at the bottle when I thought to myself, the bottle looks interesting. Picked it up, it's turned up, and we are going to crack it together. Like I say, people, I don't know nothing about this fragrance. I don't know any of the notes. I haven't seen any reviews on it. I don't know if there is any reviews out. All I do know is that I believe that this is a newer fragrance. Right, let's have a look. Right, you've got Latafa's logo there, so to speak. You've got some additional information on the back. Ingredients. I believe this is a 100ml bottle and eau de parfum concentration. All right, sleeve, as you can see. That comes off. Look at that bottle, look. It looks like a chess piece. The horse's head on top. Nice. Looks very nice. All tied in there. Right, but it's about the juice at the end of the day. Let's put that down there. We don't even need that. Cap does not click into place. That's don't pick it up by the cap. You'll be in trouble. And there is the bottle. Look, it's a big old bottle, chunky. I think it looks quite nice, to be honest with you. But, like I say, about the juice, my test strips finally turn up. Happy days. Oh, and by the way, that cap could wipe somebody out. I mean, if you chuck that at somebody's head, I think you'd kill them. That is solid metal. And then plus, look, you've got the spikes on the back. Do not drop this on your foot. Because you'd be in bits, I'm telling you, you'd be crying. Let's spray it. Enough rambling. Get a test strip out. Like I say, I've been waiting for these to turn up. And they have. Yes, sir. Let's prime the atomizer. Not a bad atomizer. God, that's nice. Couple of sprays. Let's do one on skin as well. God, that's nice. Fresh, clean, citrusy. Fresh, clean, citrusy, aromatic, a little bit woody. Grapefruit. My nose can sniff out grapefruit so good. It's like, I didn't ask for that gift, but I think this has got grapefruit in it because I am detecting it here. Definitely woody, ambroxan as well. I'm definitely getting ambroxan. So it's clean. Let me show you the bottle again. It's clean, citrusy, a little bit fruity, sweet, aromatic, a little bit woody. Yeah, this has definitely got grapefruit in it. That is jumping off my skin, the grapefruit is. That, it's got a little bit of sort of tartness to it, a little bit zesty. That's nice. To me, straight away, this is a dumb reach fragrance. I mean, when I first smelt that in the air, it does smell really good. On skin, it smells very nice. On test strip, it smells good. Straight away, Dunreach fragrance. I think in hotter weather, this will shine definitely. Cool, that's very nice. Obviously, people, let me know if you've tried this one. Let me know if you've tried any from the Mahia line. I hope I'm pronouncing it right. Let's look at the notes. Like I say, I'm definitely detecting grapefruit. Got a little bit of zestiness there. Some type of citrus. Definitely picking up woods. Definitely picking up ambroxan. It almost comes across, not musky, but it's, I don't know. Let's look at the notes. Right. Spearmint, lavender, grapefruit, lime, pineapple. Heart notes, black pepper, frankincense, geranium, juniper berry, rosemary, aromatic. Base notes, ambroxan, cashmere, oak moss, tonka bean, and vetiver. I wouldn't have been able to tell that I was detecting vetiver. I was just picking up sort of a woodsy nuance. You've got the rosemary and the juniper berry in there. I did say it's aromatic. There is a little sort of green tinge to this fragrance, ever so slightly, but that's sort of blended in with that aromatic nuance that you get. I didn't know it was pineapple. All I knew it was something fruity up top. You got the lime there, so a little bit citrusy. It is fresh. It is a little bit spicy. Overall, not a bad fragrance at all, to be honest with you. I think this is a very nice fragrance. Not wowed by it. I'm going to say this, and I don't want anyone to jump down my throat. To me, this smells ever so slightly like Sedley from Parfums de Marly. Not saying it's a clone, but why I was smelling this, or why it was up in the air, that sort of opening made my brain sort of tick a little bit. And why I've been talking to you lot, my brain's been trying to suss out which fragrance it reminded me of, ever so slightly, and it is Sedley from Parfums de Marly. Not saying it's a one-to-one clone. I don't own that fragrance. I've smelled it plenty of times, but I don't own it. So I have got a rough idea of the scent profile. And that reminded me of Sedley ever so slightly. Like I say, I'm not saying this is a clone. I don't know if this is even meant to be a clone of that fragrance, because I don't know nothing about this fragrance. I picked it up because the bottle intrigued me. And like I say, do not pick it up from the cap. Do not throw the cap at anybody, all right? Because that will cause some serious damage. Right, that's enough rambling. Let me know if you've tried this once again. Thank you for sticking with me. I'm going to say it again to everybody. Thank you for all the support. Thank you to all my subscribers. It does mean a lot. It really, really does. Remember, smelling good's always a pleasure and never a chore. And I'll definitely see you lot on the next one. Cheers.